I have verifiable proof that Tennessee is further south than Kentucky.
Is it? Or are they above them?
They're like directly above.
Okay, I just mixed it up in my head.
It's all right, dude. Nobody really knows.
They're
this
above,
map could be guessing.
They're above or below. And I assume they were below for some reason.
Yeah, well, you think of Kentucky as more rednecky.
Yeah.
That's what I do. I'm like, Kentucky, that's redneck.
Yeah.
So that must mean they're further south. That's why I always say Kentucky.
That's why I thought it, probably.
Kentucky is a deceiving state. Sorry, Los Lonely Boys. I'm trying to talk here. Kentucky is a deceiving state because they actually fought for the Union in the Civil War.
Really?
Yeah. Odd, right?
Was the dividing line of the North and the South Kentucky and Tennessee?
It was actually Maryland and Pennsylvania.
I know, but like,
oh, wait.
If that line goes to the left, mm-hmm. across.
Let me consult the map. It looks as if, okay, so actually turns out we're all wrong. Everything we said.
I didn't say shit.
Okay, well, if you would have spoken, you would have been wrong. if you drew the line, okay, so Kentucky and Tennessee is the same exact line pretty much
mm-hmm.
as Virginia, North Carolina. Mm. So that line bears no significance whatsoever. The important thing to note here is that the reason why West Virginia and Virginia are not the same state is because of the Civil War, mm. I believe. Mm-hmm. West Virginia was like, we don't want slaves or toothpaste.
And yeah, but also having North in our name, we don't want to seem like those assholes up there.
Yeah, we don't want to seem like those guys from Nova, Northern Virginia. We want to be Weaver. So yeah, Kentucky, West Virginia, and Maryland, all sleeper cell Union states for the Civil War.
Hmm.
I was very proud of that back in the day.
Like when you learned about the Civil War in school, mm-hmm. you're like, yeah, we won.
We won. We won. Maryland wanted so bad to be on the losing side. We really, really wanted to fight for the South. Abe Lincoln was like, dude, we can't lose Maryland. That literally is what, I don't think he said it exactly like that, but like along those lines. He put us under martial law.
Mm. Yeah, because they didn't want to... You know, D.C. is surrounded by Maryland, basically,
mm-hmm.
and Virginia. But, like, Virginia's too far gone.
Yeah, they were too far gone.
Yeah.
You weren't going to stop Virginia from leaving.
They're technically south of the capital, so.
They are. Yeah, that was what caused the Baltimore riots. The Baltimore riots were the people of Maryland going,
we want to fight for the South.
We want to fight for the South.
Is that real?
Huh?
Is that actually the reason?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Dude, Maryland was very divided. You know where the most, you know, Baltimore City in itself is like the most segregated city. Extrapolate that out to the state. We're a wacky, tacky state, dude. I mean, Frederick Douglass was born in what is now called Frederick, Maryland. And, you know, he was a slave. I think.
Yeah. And then he, you know, I think he got his freedom and then... Went to school and everything mm-hmm. and became a scholar. And
mm-hmm. and Mason-Dixon, the Mason-Dixon line, which is the border of Maryland and Pennsylvania, safe to say they got it wrong too. Because they definitively said that everything below this line is Southern America. And as we've had this debate countless times on the podcast, I disagree. I don't think of Maryland as a Southern state. I think of us as a northern state, dude. I mean, we have the same accent as Philly. Mm-hmm. We don't have a Virginia accent. We don't have a southern accent, you know? Now, granted, people from Jersey and stuff, they see us as southern.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
I think we're more fast-paced than southern states.
We're fast-paced.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know? Like, but then again, it's like...
We're the New York of the South.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We are the New York of the South.
I couldn't have said it better myself.
Actually, I would be willing to say we're the Boston of the South. I would say D.C. is the New York of the South.
Mm.
True.
You know what I mean? D.C.
Let's make
a
new map.
Let's make a new map.
Yeah.
Where we're the New York of the South, but we're also North.
Yeah. We're the New York of the South, but also the Florida of the North.
I would say that's more accurate. I think Baltimore is like the Atlanta of the North.
Hmm. We can't be everything.
This map is going to be so confusing. I feel like Florida makes more sense because we can call Baltimore the Miami of Maryland.
But Baltimore is so not Miami.
But also, like, Tallahassee is Essex.
That's true. Tallahassee
you think,
is Essex.
Like, Florida's big.
Florida's big. They got a lot of cities. We only have, like, two cities to play with, and one of them isn't even really our city. We got Baltimore, D.C., kind of. D.C. Mm-hmm. used to be part of Maryland. And then in the worst trade deal ever, we were like, actually, they don't get a thing in the Electoral College?
Mm-mm. Oh. That's why there's the thing that people want to make D.C. a state.
Yeah, but I would... Okay, so would you rather see D.C. become a state or see D.C. become Maryland again?
Make D.C. Maryland again.
I kind of want it to be Maryland.
I think that's a good slogan. Yeah. When I run for governor...
I just want all those... You know, we need those tax dollars.
We need D.C., dude. I mean, what the fuck? It's a city of 400,000 or 600... There's a lot of thousands of people there. Mm-hmm. And they should...
And it's so tiny.
They're so tiny. So then they used to be us, and now they're just not us. They should be us.
Mm-hmm.
They should be us.
And they... Because it's the DMV... Mm-hmm. It's not the DDMV. That'll change everything.
It will change.
So DC is Maryland again, and then all the government buildings are basically like their own little Vatican, you know?
Yes. Yes. They are kind of, yeah, DC is the, okay, let's go back to our original thing here.
Yeah.
If Baltimore is the Miami of the North.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Then
the DC is
House of Representatives is the...
The Vatican City.
The Vatican City of...
of the West.
I am kind of liking the idea of double DMV and the logo.
Double DMV, yeah.
Because of D.C. and Delaware. But is West Virginia considered part of DMV? Doesn't seem like vibe.
There's no W in
it. No, I don't think there's any khaki pants in West Virginia.
They're two over there. They're basically California.
They're basically, yeah. West Virginia is a California of the East, as we call it.
They are laid back.
I'd actually say maybe...
Slower pace.
Maybe it's like an Arizona.
Because
There's no water. There's no water to make it redeeming. But.
Yeah. Dude, honestly, West Virginia is kind of its own thing. It's like it's Appalachia or Appalachian. Do you say Appalachian or Appalachian?
Neither. I think I say Appalachian.
I don't say that word enough to know.
I've never said that word.
I think
word
I
before.
Say Appalachian.
Appalachian.
Appalachian. Right? Yeah, that sounds right.
Yeah, Appalachian sound. I've been watching a lot of like weird interviews on YouTube,
mm-hmm.
and a lot of like there's this YouTube channel called Soft White Underbelly, and they just interview like a bunch of. I think the premise of it is to just interview like the lowest in our society, not lowest in that way, but I think that's his idea. It's like he does a lot of interviews with like drug addicts and like prostitutes and pimps and whatever. And then also he does interviews with just people from the Appalachian Mountains. No particular problems. Just you're from West Virginia. Come on this interview. You're basically the same as a drug addict prostitute. The way that I'm looking at it. And I don't see it that way. Of course I don't see it that way. Until you watch the interview, then you're like, wow, this guy.
Does he like ham it up or like is it very serious?
He does a very good job of interviewing. He just like talks to people and they're just like, yeah, you know, my grandfather owned that mountain over there and then we sold that mountain and now we got this mountain. Like that's pretty dope. Like we make fun of people from West Virginia, but it's like they own like mountains and stuff.
Yeah, they own land.
I don't own any land.
Mm-mm.
That's a very city thing to like rent an apartment. Like you don't even own the place that you live.
Yeah, just tricking yourself into paying more and not getting any privacy or owning anything.
Exactly. Then you look at a guy in West Virginia who's like riding a four-wheeler over a fucking hill he made in his own backyard and like shooting squirrels from his deck and you're like, this fucking loser.
This hillbilly.
This loser. Meanwhile, he probably talks to his neighbors more than fucking we do. Who knows? Guys, we're doing a lot of American talk for such a festive Mexican holiday. Mexico, of course, being the United States of the South. It is Cinco de Mayo, one of my favorite holidays. Live from the studio, I'm Jimmy Selesky.
I'm Eric Glazer.
And we're coming at you with some Corona Lights, courtesy of Alex Glazer, back.
Yeah, our special guest.
Special guest. Alex couldn't wait to come on the pod. I was like, dude, he was like, dude, can I please come on the Cinco de Mayo cast?
That's my, I don't think I've ever said it's my favorite holiday, but I'm excited for this year.
Yeah. We should have done a St. Pat. You guys are Irish. We should have done this on St. Patrick's Day.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know? We should have gotten like a Latino guest. Something. Why did we get you?
I don't know. I don't really know much Spanish either.
I mean, you did bring Corona Lights. So. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Which it's is fun festive. That they're kind of fun for this again. Mm-hmm. Whereas before we were kind of paying tribute to the coronavirus, but now we can kind of actually get back to buying them just once a year.
Yeah.
Yeah. Going back to the culture.
Although I will say we discussed the stocks of Corona when coronavirus started happening. Because first of all, the stock in the word coronavirus plummeted after May 2022 or 2020. I remember when COVID first came out, everyone called it coronavirus. And I used to think it was annoying when people would call it COVID. Like in March 2020, every now and then you'd see like one person be like COVID. And I was like, I compared it to like when you hear like a weed person call weed cannabis. Mm-hmm. I was like, dude, people that call coronavirus COVID are the same as people that call weed cannabis. And then suddenly it's interesting to see how stuff shifts. COVID became the norm. Nobody calls it coronavirus anymore.
Coronavirus is just too long.
It's too long. Except my, what was the place? Papa John's, one of those, maybe Domino's.
Oh, yeah. They still call it coronavirus.
Yeah.
Domino's does.
Because I got a pizza delivery, and he wouldn't bring it up because he said their corporate policy is they can't enter the building because of coronavirus. Mm. I was like, really?
Which is actually the actual like way it should be said. Because the virus, like coronavirus is the thing and mm-hmm. COVID is the disease, right?
I don't know. I just didn't, I was like, I don't really believe that because you're using an outdated term. Mm-hmm. I think that was an old rule.
I don't really believe in COVID, Domino's.
Like, I didn't care that he didn't want to come in, like if he didn't feel safe. But the fact that he said coronavirus threw up a red flag. I was like, that sounds like an old rule.
Yeah, I'm going to Papa John's. They'll go in any
Oh,
building.
It was Pizza Hut. My bad.
Oh, Pizza Hut.
Yeah.
Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah. That actually makes more sense. Yeah. For some reason. For whatever reason.
Papa
that makes
John's and Domino's. They're cutting edge. But they're Pizza up on Hut, living in the
yeah.
past.
Yeah. You out pizza'd them, dude. Jeez. Yeah, Cinco de Mayo, festive day, festive times, not just for the country of Mexico, but more importantly, the city of Towson. Had our Towson Festival this past weekend, which I know you made a pass at, correct?
I wasn't able to make it.
You didn't make it at all?
Mm-mm.
How about you, Eric?
I tried to go on Sunday, but we did like the super long walk at Loch Raven. Mm-hmm. And then on the way back, I was like, oh, Towson Festival, let's get food. Right when we got near the vicinity, it started pouring down rain.
Yeah, that's what happened to me on Sunday,
and I was like,
too.
Fuck, okay. Not this year again, I guess.
Yeah. Saturday was definitely the day to go. Everyone was out. I saw so many people. Sunday, I went, but I went like mad early. Mm-hmm. I actually wish I got rained out because I was embarrassed. I got embarrassed at the Towson Festival.
Yeah, how come?
Well, they have this
Were
challenge.
You there by yourself?
No, that would have been too embarrassing. I was slightly less embarrassed by one of the... I got carnied, dude. A carnival trick got me.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. Well, first of all, we had a nice we had this conversation with Dan and Marissa that night, the night before.
We had a nice conversation with them.
Where we were discussing how the Towson Festival, unlike the Fells Point Festival in recent years, still makes you drink beer in the beer garden exclusively, mm-hmm. which I thought, I never really thought of it. I don't think anybody really thought anything of it until COVID happened. And then they just started letting you drink in the streets. And then we were like, wait. Why don't we always do this? Why do we not do this all the time?
Yeah.
You have that same realization when you go to New Orleans. You're like, why isn't there just a marching band in York Road at all times? I don't understand why we don't do this. You know, I do get it from a certain perspective. It's like on Bourbon Street, you like walk out of one bar with a drink, and then you walk into another bar with that same drink, and they make zero money whatsoever. But obviously, you know, you're going to get another drink at that bar, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
You know? I don't know. But Towson Fest is still holding strong with the fucking beer garden, which, like I mentioned in our nice conversation with Dan and Marissa, it promotes drunkenness. Because when you're in the beer garden, you want to not be in the beer garden. You want to just be there for the beer. And then you want to be able to...
nothing's really going on in the beer garden.
Yeah, you have...
Like, I'm sorry, the Amish Outlaws weren't there again?
The Amish Outlaws, I don't know if they played this year, actually.
Dang.
We were watching some, like, band that should... Let's just say we were watching a band that should have been us. That was my thought. I was like, this band should be us. The beer garden's cool sometimes,
mm-hmm.
but, like, you know... I had to, at the age of 29, I had to sneak out. Normally, you got to sneak. When you're 19, you sneak into the beer garden. When you're 29, you sneak out of the beer garden. That's what I did. So we got our beers. We put them in cups. And then we, like, found, like, a little wedge in the fence.
Oh, shit.
And, like, shimmied out of there. And then, like, passed, like, six state troopers. Who, you know.
Couldn't care less.
They couldn't care less. Because I think even the state troopers get that, like, dude, we're going to let this guy drink. Why?
Yeah. I mean, they'd probably stop a young kid from going in there.
Mm-hmm.
But you're an adult. You're just trying to play a fucking carny game with beer.
But 29-year-olds are the kids of adults. Mm. Like, if I was an old man, when I'm an old man, I don't intend on following any rules whatsoever.
Yeah.
Because the whole premise of me being scared of cops is that usually they're older than me. And I look at people older than me with at least some form of authority.
Mm-hmm.
The prospect of me being 72 years old and having some 24-year-old cadet talk to me, I just can't see it. I can't see me caring.
I will respect them. But I do agree. I'm gonna do like hard drugs when I'm old.
It's the balance of respecting your elders and respecting authority. So mm-hmm. like they kind of, you know, they cancel out a little bit, and then you're just an old guy talking to a young guy.
Mm-hmm.
Most cops are younger than us already.
That's true.
Right now.
Mm-hmm. That's true. But they're like within the same ballpark of us,
mm-hmm.
like same generation.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
they look kind of look up to us.
Yeah. Remember when we got pulled over for jaywalking in Ocean City?
Yeah.
And the cops were like 21 years old
mm-hmm.
with Jesus. Like fake IDs.
Yeah.
I was like, do you guys have fake IDs?
You guys know where we can get
cool.
some?
They were pretty cool.
Can you
cool.
guys buy us beer?
The cops asking us.
Yeah. I'll probably steal when I'm old, too.
You know, I don't see myself stealing, but I do see myself forgetting to pay.
Mm.
Yeah. Or what about taking out a lot of credit cards and just like racking up a ton of debt?
You're talking about white collar crime at this point. You're talking about going full,
oh my God.
Full old guy. That is one of the things about like life is that if you're dead, who cares? Like mm-hmm. if you have nothing, like. If I had no family, and I don't understand why more people don't do this, honestly. If I had no family, no kids, relatives of any sort, why don't you just, and you know you're like 80 years old, why don't you just ball out on a credit card?
Mm-hmm.
And then you die, and mm-hmm. they're just like, well, he spent all this money. Who do we get this money from? And they're like, I don't know. He didn't have any kids. He wasn't married.
Mm-hmm.
No living relatives. Like, what do you do? Call up his, like, best friend? Like, who did he text the most? Make this guy. It's like, you can't.
That's why I wouldn't want to leave my family with all that debt, mm-hmm. which is why I think a lot of people take their family with them when they...
Oh, my God.
...unalive themselves.
Jesus Christ.
That it seems to be the solution to the problem. Well, these are all great future plans. I come to find that the reason actually was that the state troopers were actually trying to look out for me to stop me from embarrassing myself on this carnival game. And they play upon people like me, dude. Mm-hmm. They look for a guy walking with a girl
and snuck beer into snuck a cup.
Beer. This guy thinks he can do things that others can't. Mm. So let's put him to the test. And so we walk up and there's this game and it's called the Hang 100 for 100 Challenge. And what it is there's a bar, a pull-up bar. And the challenge is you have to hang on it for 90 seconds for a girl or 2 minutes as a guy. It costs $10 to enter. Mm-hmm. And if you do it, you win 100. That's a good deal. Mm-hmm. I spent $15 on a gyro. I can spend $10 to hang on a bar. Now, what they don't tell you is that this bar is not stationary. It rotates.
Oh, no.
It doesn't rotate automatically, but it's like it's not settled in. It's just like...
Yeah.
And I was annoyed because I didn't think about it at the time, but as I was stepping up to the bar and I felt it rotating, I was like, oh, my God, I totally watched a whole YouTube video on this. You know? This
is how it's a scam?
This, yes. This is the whole reason why if there's any benefit to watching YouTube 23 hours a day, it's that you wind up in weird rabbit holes where now I'm looking up all the best carnival scams to avoid. And then all of it goes
then
right
you
up.
Only remember it when you're already in the scam.
As I'm already being scammed. I'm like, oh, I remember this. You're not supposed to remember it was a scam until after. I knew immediately. I was like, this is not going to end well for me. Because the whole premise of it is like when you're on a stationary bar, mm-hmm. you can kind of like it's finger strength. So like you grab it with a firm grip and then you can kind of like push your palm, like your upper palm into the bar and kind of like use that to mitigate your weight. But mm-hmm. if you do that with this, it just makes the bar spin. So now you're constantly trying to fucking do this mm-hmm. and like, so like you start off with a strong grip, but as your grip fades naturally, normally, if it was a stationary
you
bar,
you go like one way.
You're a fucking genius. That is the trick.
Ah,
that is the trick.
Was that
cross
on YouTube?
Grip. It was on YouTube.
I've seen you do that at the gym too before.
Yeah, practicing for that exact moment, and I fucking blew it. I fucking blew it. I barely made it a minute.
Damn.
And I was embarrassed. I'm not gonna lie.
You know, it's really impressive. Carnies or carnival.
Barkers.
Engineers.
Carnival engineers.
They are like physics experts.
Yeah.
All their little tricks are all about this ball is too light because when it hits that shallow cup, it's going to bounce out. It's not going to stay. Like, that's physics, I think. Yeah.
It is
I never
physics.
Took physics.
That is physics. It is physics. It is annoying that it's physics, but it's physics.
Yeah.
Like, and then they always like, you know, like this guy seemed like a cool guy, you know? But it's
he watched the same video you did, and he's like, damn, I know a way to make a lot of money now.
Honestly, it's kind of smart. I mean, you're not really, like, I do think that they should, like, advertise that the bar moves, because most people wouldn't even think anything of it. They'd just be like, okay, the moving bar, who cares? Mm. You know? I don't know. The point is that I made it a minute, and then as I fell off the bar, I just heard the sound of my girlfriend go, what? That's not what you want to hear at any time from your girlfriend. There's no moment when you want to hear your girlfriend go, what? I'm dating him? So, of course, the whole rest of the fucking time, I'm just like...
No, you gotta... I'll throw on the video when we get back.
Oh, I did. Oh, I did. As soon as we got back, I just went to my YouTube carnival hang scam.
Did a lot of people see it?
All the people that I sent it to
said,
Joe.
Said, here you,
he
here you.
No, like when you were hanging from the bar, did a lot of people witness it?
A lot of people.
Kids too? Yeah,
kids saw me fail. Children.
No.
Children. I fucking fall at the bar. The guy's like, come on, man. There are kids here. How are you going to fucking fail? Yeah, dude. So I actually gave up on the rest of that day. I just slept. Fell asleep.
On the rest of the day, you lost at the carnival?
Yeah. I went home, drove Liv to her car so she could go to work. Didn't say a word. Went directly back home and just went to sleep.
Jeez.
Yeah, it was not good. It was not good.
Damn, dude.
But yeah, Towson Fest, dude. That's
Damn, that sound did so fun. That sounded like the best.
It was the best, dude. Truly, truly. But yeah, dude, you didn't go.
I didn't go.
Amazing.
There's too much stuff going on this weekend.
What did you do this weekend?
It was Lindsay's birthday. I had a couple birthdays, and then I feel like every spring festival was this weekend.
Yeah.
The Maryland Film Festival was this weekend. The Mount Vernon Flower Mart.
Yeah.
Towson Fest. Like every thing picked this weekend.
What is the... Do we know any films in the Maryland Film Festival?
I didn't even look into it this year, honestly.
Really? Well, you're done with film festivals after your last experience.
I'm kind of done with them.
Yeah.
Maryland Film Festival has also gone downhill the past several years, even before COVID, because they switched the director of programming. Mm-hmm. So it hadn't been as exciting.
Mm-hmm.
So I kind of forgot about it.
Yeah, the only reason I knew is because I went to go see the... Like Everywhere, All the Time, whatever movie that's called.
Mm-hmm.
Like the Michelle Kwan or whatever her name is from Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon.
Was it you telling me I should watch that?
Probably Eric.
Probably me.
Okay.
Because Eric told me that it was really, you said it was really good, right?
Yeah, it was so good. But
it's like interdimensional, right?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Very cool. It's by the guys that did Turn Down for What music video and also Swiss Army Man. But I brought that up because when we were parking down by the Charles, they said that this week was going to get blocked off down there for the film festival.
Well, how was the movie? Can you tell us about it without spoiling it?
Not really. Other than just like all the effects were so cool. They did a lot of them like in camera, meaning like... They did a lot of, like, you know, stunts. Like, even Jamie Lee Curtis, who's in it.
Oh, she's in it?
Did, like, a wire stunt.
Oh, no.
Like, for a fight scene.
Damn.
But, yeah. Definitely check it out. I don't want to spoil anything. It's a good-ass fucking movie.
Well, you kind of already did by telling me Jamie Lee Curtis is in it. I'm over Jamie Lee Curtis.
Damn.
And this movie's spoiled for me now.
Oh, no.
I just am. I know we've talked about
that. Know who
else
is in it? Short Round.
Who's that?
The guy from Indiana Jones, the little Asian boy.
Oh, really?
He's the husband.
His name is Short Round?
That's what his name was in the movie.
Okay.
Hmm.
Okay.
Not his real name.
I was about to say, that's a ridiculous name.
First name Short, last name Round.
Like, jeez Louise, dude. Probably. Can you toss me another one of those Corona Lights, please?
Mm-hmm. What's the history of Cinco de Mayo? Isn't it very American?
It's like their Independence Day, basically, right?
Or, yes. I mean, the way that we celebrate it is kind of not...
Well, look...
I mean, we celebrate it like we celebrate St. Patrick's Day and, like, pretty much any other culture's holiday that, like, is a large holiday in America is just, yes, we get to drink, and we'll maybe have the food that we think of when we think of that culture.
Ba-boom.
And celebrate it as respectfully.
I had a burrito today.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
And St. Patrick's Day, I had, you know, potatoes or something.
Well, to be fair, that's how we celebrate our own Independence Day, too.
We eat hot dogs.
We eat the food we think we would eat.
Yeah.
I feel like I would eat a burger and a hot dog. So, therefore, I will. I also feel like I would drink. And then I do.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Happy 4th of July, you know? And everybody walks around looking like Uncle Sam. Not really. Actually, we don't dress. We don't really do that for 4th of July, do we? We don't dress up. We dress down. I definitely dress down on
people
the floor.
Like wear fucking like flags, cutoffs, and like
red,
American
and
flag
blue.
Cutoffs and shit, and red, white, and blue. And people at the Legion dress up as Scottish people or some shit.
Yeah, that's strange.
Yeah, the kilt.
I don't get that.
Realize this is American, right?
Hmm.
Yeah, the history of Cinco de Mayo, I wish you would have asked me this last year, because last year for our Cinco de Mayo cast, I actually spent the day researching what it meant, and then I remembered about 13% of it when the podcast started. And this year, I think I'm down to 1% of what I remember from last year.
And that was just me remembering that I did that work last year.
Yeah, I remembered that I did that. So that was it. The history of Cinco de Mayo... basically something having to do with Mexico beating another country. Let's call it France?
Mm-hmm.
Or Portugal?
Mm-hmm.
A country.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
They...
I'll drink to that.
I'll drink to that. Somebody get us a round of tacos over here. Mexico beat a country, I think, on the 5th of May.
I thought about bringing over one of those party packs from Taco Bell with the 12 tacos.
That'd been amazing.
No cheese.
That would've been amazing. We should have done a power hour for tacos, soft shell tacos.
But I didn't want to have another accident here.
One bite every fucking minute. Do you think that's doable? If you had to take a bite of a taco every minute for an hour?
Yeah, you'd need a couple tacos, though.
You'd need a couple tacos.
Mm-hmm.
This is what, you're taking basically 60 bites.
That's a lot of bites.
How many bites is in a taco? How many bites do you take a taco down in?
Four solid bites.
Four bites?
So that's 15 tacos.
Yeah, four to five.
Four to five.
I could eat... I usually have 10 to 12 tacos.
Me too. Me too.
Especially when I make them at home.
Yeah.
They just are like air...
Mm-hmm. They really are, dude. There is no... I'm glad that we're talking about Taco Bell on Cinco de Mayo Day. it's what Simon Bolivar would have wanted. Whatever his name was. That's not even the guy. it's what George Lopez would have wanted.
You should have played that as the...
We should have. We should have. what the fuck were you saying? Oh, Taco Bell. Yeah, I feel like I can eat an endless amount of Taco Bell. Like, endless amounts. Also, I feel like I could spend endless amounts of money there, too. Mm-hmm. Sometimes when I get Uber Eats from Taco Bell, it'll be like $60.
Mm. Yeah, like, but then you'll get like 20 things delivered.
Yeah, that's true, too.
Mm-hmm.
That's true. But I eat all of it. I'll get two cheesy gordita crunches, like four soft shell tacos. They are air.
Yeah,
that's like saying, hey, can you give me a couple straws with my Diet Coke?
Especially
give me a couple
crunchy tacos, especially, are just like nothing. That's
you're
like a rice
crunchy
cake.
Taco guy.
I'm saying I can take the most volume.
Don't back
in.
Up now, dude. Are you a crunchy taco guy or
I can,
not?
I can take the most volume in with crunchy tacos.
Yeah, because a crunchy taco is what, four chips basically.
It's like a rice cake. It's like nothing.
Yeah, it's four tortilla chips.
And I'm also kind of talking about when I make tacos at home. You know, when you put the crunchy shells in the oven for a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
I just eat the whole pack.
Mm. I don't understand the science behind a hard shell taco. Like, there's certain...
Corn tortilla that's fried.
I get that. I get...
I like both crunchy and soft shell, by the way.
What science part, though?
I was going to bring both tonight.
The science of eating it. Like, okay, like...
Yeah, like it crumbles after the first bite. That's why I don't like
that's
them.
Silly.
No. You know what I can't understand? Talk about engineers. When I make crunchy tacos at home, they do crunch and fall apart.
Mm-hmm.
Taco Bell and Chipotle, their crunchy tacos somehow hold together. Do you notice that?
Mm.
They're crunchy, but they're still a little leathery. Leathery.
Leathery.
Crunchy, so, but leathery. They hold together.
I bet they're not. So like for the hard shell tacos at the store... They're fried, but then also like dehydrated. So then there's no moisture when they pack them up. But at a Chipotle or a Qdoba or whatever, Taco Bell, they might like fry the shell there.
Mm-hmm.
But also, I could be wrong.
Hmm. I'm sure. Done with Chipotle.
You're yeah. done with it?
Yeah, I just kind of don't crave it anymore.
Mm.
Maybe in a couple years.
Couple years,
I'll
come
back
to
around.
It.
Yeah,
Chipotle's been pissing me off recently. Sometimes you'll literally walk in there and they'll be like online orders only, and I'm like, why?
Mm-hmm.
I'm literally here.
Yeah,
I'm literally here.
It's like, okay, I'm gonna order it on my phone and still stand here and wait for it.
It's silly, dude. Well, like we were talking about before, COVID holdovers with like stupid things that like people still use as an excuse. That might be the ultimate. That might be the ultimate thing when they're just like like so many businesses started getting away with such ridiculous policies.
Yeah, because it's saving them headcount and they turned their jobs into like computers.
Well, mm-hmm. then also they don't have to worry about having good customer service because they like basically put a stop between the employees talking to people.
Oh, my gosh. Speaking of holdovers.
Oh, wait, let me say this real quick. Yes. I got Qdoba for lunch today because of Cinco de Mayo.
Mm-hmm. Nice, nice, nice.
But I was like really thrown off when I got there because I saw someone had their lunch on the table, like behind the bar. I guess where like the prep station is, so they're like cutting up all the food and shit.
Uh-huh.
But they had like their Chick-fil-A bag, and they're like half eating.
Oh, it was like their personal food. Lunch.
Yeah. So I was like, this is kind of awkward.
Yeah, that's fucking weird.
I actually respect
maybe
that.
Not want to go back to that.
You respect that?
I respect that it was Chick-fil-A. I would have been more annoyed if it was like their own little Tupperware and like some little dish they made.
Yeah, true.
Like eat that in the back. But if it was like another fast food, like that's chill.
Yeah.
They're in a rush. They're
busy.
It's
funny. You see them doing that, and it would kind of make me feel weird, too. But it's also the reality that, like...
There's probably no time for them.
And also, you know that every other place you go to is doing, like... If they're not eating right in front of you, they're, like, eating in the back.
Hell yeah. I'd be picking right out of the cheese string. Little shredded cheese.
Dude, oh, my God. Constantly.
Yeah.
Dude, I was the worst when it came to that.
Me, too.
The worst.
At any food kind of job.
If, Yeah, dude, I would even eat the other half of people's burgers sometimes.
Well, he did that on and off the clock.
Oh, yeah.
Anywhere we went.
Dude, I literally, like, I said this a billion times too, but I always had that rule. If I'd make out with you or I'd hang out with you, I'll eat your food.
But, I mean, like, you'd do that to strangers too.
That's
I remember
what I'm saying.
Vivid.
If I would make out with that stranger.
If they look cool.
Or I'd hang out with that stranger. Like, if I see a stranger and I'm like, and like I talked to, obviously I'm serving the table. Like I can get a good read on a person based off the hours long of interactions we have. If he seems like a cool dude, it's like, could I picture myself at a bar with this guy, sitting at the bar, drinking beer? He gets a burger. He can't finish. And he goes, yo, you want the rest of this? And we're like sitting talking about fucking crypto or something, whatever guys talk about at the bar. And I'm just like, yeah, I'll crush the rest of it. If I could picture that in my mind, then I'm going to eat your food.
Yeah, but I remember vividly a situation where we were at like Main Street Oyster House. It was in Bel Air.
Mm-hmm.
I think you were coming out to see like a comedy show with me. I forget if I was on it or not.
Oh, yeah. I remember this exactly.
But we were sitting at the bar and like a guy either to the like left of you or me had like half of a burger or crab cake or something. And he like pushed it back to the bartender. And you're like, hey, you're done eating that?
And I did
like,
that?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
And then you're like, you mind if I have it as you're like grabbing for it?
You know who else does that? Our Uncle Bill.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
That's funny.
Famous for it.
I can't believe
you haven't done that in a while, but
so
I just
remember
being like, damn. Like
I don't really know if our Uncle Bill's famous for that. I saw him do it one time at the Cheesecake Factory.
Yeah.
He took another stranger's food?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
They were getting up to leave, and he asked, are you going to box that up? And they said, no.
Sometimes I have to fight the urge at gigs sometimes. Like, because at Perennial, there's, like, they set up the music literally, like, right next to the table right there.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes people just, like, not
They'll
eat their
leave.
Food.
Yeah.
And it'll be, like, within reaching distance, like, a whole bowl of fries. And I'm just like... I just keep on wondering. They just keep on living. I cannot believe I do that. That's even low for me, dude. I can't even believe I did that. That's fucking low.
Nah. That was also while you're probably working in restaurants,
mm-hmm.
and it was more of just a common thing to be like, all right, you guys done that? Take it back to the kitchen and grub it down.
Mm-hmm.
Because that's understandable.
Yeah.
That's not weird to me. But it was very funny in the moment because I was like, damn, dude, Jimmy has balls just to ask a stranger for their food.
That's no fucking bueno.
I kept getting in trouble at my high school job because I was eating like $30 worth of like tenderloin, filet mignon. Just like snacking on it through my whole shift.
Oh my God.
And then I eventually did get let go because of that. Because I was so hungry little guy.
Well, that was used to bring home like chicken wings and stuff for me and dad.
Yeah.
Feeding my family.
If I saw something I liked, I took it. And then when they fired me, they were like, I think I said like I was just hungry. And like they were like... I mean, if you think about it, that's when, like, I was going through puberty. Like, I probably was starving.
Yeah.
You know, like I was...
I'm going through puberty. I'm so hungry. Your voice is cracking. Are you going to finish that? off your fucking boss's desk.
I was growing like crazy. And he was like, we help people every day. If you would have told us that you needed help, we could have set up a plan to help feed you. And I swear to God, I tried to go that angle. And then it didn't work and I got fired.
You tried to go.
Oh, my God.
Like, our parents fed us when we went through puberty.
That's amazing. And you know what the solution here is, dude? For any restaurant owners, because I still haven't forgotten what I was going to say about the fucking Towson Diner. The solution here is you should, if you want to cut back on employees eating food at work, give everyone a free meal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Done deal. How much does it cost you to say, yeah, you can get some chicken tenders every shift you work? You're working 7 hours here. Fuck the discount. Here's a plate of chicken tenders. Or have what Ruth's Chris did, which is family meal. And they would just have a big buffet in the back set up of all kinds of food. So then instead of the servers eating fucking people's half-eaten steak off the plates, then you just go back. You're like, oh, I'm a little hungry. You go in the fucking thing. You get a little of this, get a little of that. That's the way you cut back on that, dude.
Yeah.
Now, the Towson Diner. Are you allowed to call yourself a diner if you close at 10 p.m.?
Since when? Oh, after COVID they did
They
this?
Are no longer 24/7.
Since COVID, right?
Is Nautilus 24?
Yes, I think so. And actually, maybe not.
They used to be. I mean, they both used to be.
I think every diner capitalized on this idea. And bars do this too. Now bars think they can just close before last call.
Mm-hmm.
That's fucking weird.
I mean, they can.
They can. But like the whole point is to be open. You're a bar. You're supposed to be open.
I guess the diner finally realized, like, the only people who come in here for booze at, like, 7 a.m., we don't want them in here.
I mean,
when we're the only place serving alcohol.
I don't know, dude. I feel like they should pass a law that says you can't call yourself a diner unless you're open 24/7. That's literally what diners are for.
Mm-hmm.
You're supposed to be able to go to the diner at any moment. Any moment.
Mm-hmm. And get anything on the menu.
Yeah. That's the fucking point.
Damn. Diners were the original cheesecake.
What do you mean?
Because they just have massive menus with like everything. On
them. Mm-hmm. Let's see. Let's get into some topics here, guys. Big topics.
Big news.
Big news. Now, we're a little behind on the news, so we're going to start back from the jump. First order of business. This happened last week. This was what everybody was pissed off about before everybody was pissed off about what everybody's pissed off about this week.
Okay.
And that is our boy Elon buying Twitter.
He's our boy.
Is he our boy? I don't know.
I don't know.
I don't know. I kind of fuck
I don't him. Know the guy.
I don't know him. He seems cool. The reason I bring this up is because...
So did he really do that, or is this just like a big...
It's real.
Did he really buy
troll
Twitter?
Thing. Yeah, I don't know.
He's like a majority holder or something. I don't know how anything works. I just feel like... I think he owns like 9.6% stock in fucking Twitter, which means that he owns more than like anybody. And there was this whole thing where they tried to do this thing called like the poison pill, which... If you're trying to make a deal, that seems like a bad name for a deal. You know, like, hey, I tell you what, we're going to negotiate with this poison pill. It's like, really, dude? I don't know. That doesn't sound safe. And then he kind of just did some other shit, some rich guy shit. This is when you really understand the classes in society. When somebody explains mergers and acquisitions and how people purchase things, and I could have it explained to me over and over again. I could fall asleep with somebody in my ear just explaining it to me and wake up and just have no fucking idea anything about it. The reason I ask is because this spurred a big debate in my mind because I saw an interesting tweet, which is an African American has purchased Twitter, which is oddly technically true.
South African American.
South African American.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Mm-hmm. I guess, technically.
Mm-hmm.
It's strange. Why I don't want to make you guys go into troubled water here. Oh my God.
Why is
God.
It strange, Jimmy?
It's strange. Well, okay. So I guess the point I was driving at is...
I mean, it's just like Mean Girls. When Lindsay Lohan got brought into the class, they're like, guys, we have a new African-American student coming in. Everyone thought she was going to be a black girl. Mm-hmm. Nope, Lindsay Lohan. Her parents are fucking archaeologists or some shit.
That actually helped me understand what's happened last week with this whole acquisition.
What?
Yeah.
Mean Girls? That analogy.
The Mean Girls reference.
Yeah. It adds up a little more now.
Mm-hmm. It just, like, the whole thing was like, it just kind of like got me because I was like, it really goes to show that, like, no matter what the fuck happens, it will become the biggest deal ever. And, like, I could not bring myself to understand why it was such a thing last week that he did that. Like, I always thought he was kind of cool on Twitter, you know?
It was shocking to me. Not that it was him. It was just shocking that he did it and that they actually sold.
Yeah.
You know?
And that's...
It's kind of exciting. Like, I'm curious what he's going to do with it because they haven't, like, joined Meta. You know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm. there's a very few, like, independent social platforms still.
Well, that's what... I'm glad you brought up Meta because last time you were on the podcast, we talked about the metaverse.
Yeah.
Like... We understand that every social media company is owned by a billionaire.
Mm-hmm.
No dude like us owns Twitter. You don't like meet the owner of fucking Instagram and it's like just a dude. Like they're all billionaires. So like everybody's like, a fucking billionaire bought Twitter. It's like, yeah, dude, guess who owned it before? Another billionaire. And all the people that you were talking about, like, oh, it's such a safe platform, it's like we had integrity. It's like, well, those guys all sold it, didn't they? Like somebody on that board had to be like, yeah, fuck it. Mm-hmm. Like, so like they couldn't have been all that great either if this was this massive threat or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
I don't understand. Honestly, the only thing I was excited about was big idea. He's proposing a fucking edit button.
Yeah, that's
huge.
That's what I was gonna say.
Why can't you edit a tweet right. in 2022?
That's the only thing I've heard that he's doing, so I'm cool with him owning it.
Yeah,
if he wants to do that,
like a dislike button.
A dislike button be
there is one now. Remember, I showed you my Twitter got the update. There's upvoting and downvoting on tweets now.
Oh, really? Weird.
Mm-hmm.
That I honestly support that because I feel like if you could incorporate dislikes into my Twitter stats, I could really blow up. Like I get like one like per tweet ever, which sucks. The Twitter economics is so different, though. It's like one, if you get 5 likes on Twitter, I consider that the equivalent of like 100 likes on Facebook. Like it's huge, mm-hmm. you know? But I think that with all the stuff about like with social media affecting people's lives and shit like that, I feel like there will be some pushback against like having a dislike button because it just allows mm-hmm. people to feel shittier. Mm-hmm. Like you already feel shitty enough when you tweet something and nobody likes it.
Yeah.
But just imagine if instead of 0 likes, you had like negative 50. Like, that's not good.
I don't think Elon's going to let that happen.
I think he will let that happen, dude.
Nah, he probably wouldn't like that because I feel like he'd get like down, like not like bombed or some shit. You know what I mean? Like, there'd be people try to ratio him all the time.
Yeah. Well, or they could do what Reddit did, which is you can't go below 0, which explains why most of my Reddit posts ever were 0. Because you start with 1, right?
I don't know.
When's the last time you've been on Reddit?
While. I don't use my Reddit account anymore. Like, I'll go on it for, like, Reddit's very good for... It's like kind of the new Google of like trying to figure out like a technical issue or something. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Like that's where most people ask that kind of shit. And that's where you can find most answers now.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not like posting shit on Reddit. You know what I mean?
It's just strange that like when Mark Zuckerberg released the metaverse thing, everybody just kind of like made fun of it, but nobody was like terrified. Nobody... Were you terrified? I remember explicitly you being very excited about the prospect of the metaverse.
No, if I recall correctly,
you were not nervous.
I was nervous about a different kind of attacks that could occur in there and assaults.
I remember you being stoked about it.
No, Eric hates it. Didn't you say you don't trust it? Or we didn't trust it?
I don't know. I don't really think it's ever going to take off, to be honest.
You don't?
Not really. I think what they're trying to like bill it as right now as like this new way to like hang out and shit, like maybe I can see some people doing that, but I don't think that's going to be the thing that makes everyone like, let's like, you know, take it to another dimension. Metaphor or okay. An example.
Mm-hmm.
Just being like, before like Halo came out, you didn't really want it. You didn't need an Xbox. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But like once they had like a killer app like Halo or like, I don't know, fucking whatever. Like the big game everyone wanted to get, like Super Smash Bros. You got to get a fucking Nintendo for that.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's going to be a while before VR has something like that. That like even like, because you're not even really into video games. So like that wouldn't work for you.
Wouldn't get me
in there. If there's like a crazy cool VR game and you see it and you're like, oh, that's cool, but I'm not going to buy VR to do this.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to have to be something that's like mass appeal. Like everyone can get into it.
Peloton.
Yeah.
Very easy to, yeah, kind of Peloton. Porn. Like it would have to be a Peloton thing.
And you know, I hope Elon doesn't fuck that up about Twitter.
More people jerk off to porn than exercise.
Yeah, but that's not going to be like, I don't think. That's going to help drive the market for sure.
It's going to.
But that's not going to be the thing that like gets it in everyone's house.
I think it will. I think everyone's house is going to have something like it's going to be embarrassing at first. But then again, buying condoms was embarrassing at first for most people. But once it becomes the norm, everybody's going to fucking do it. I think that porn, there is a great unifier, and that's what's going to get us in. And that's why the only reason I even brought any of this up is because you look at Mark Zuckerberg with this fucking, what I consider to be a crazy diabolical plan.
Mm-hmm.
And he just like gets away. Scott, nobody, there's no fucking major outrage. Everybody's fucking talking about it, blah, 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 blah. And they have another guy who buys Twitter and he's like, yo, what if we had an edit button? And people are like, are you kidding me? Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
It's very clear in these times that so much of the whole thing seems to be manufactured. So much of the reaction is manufactured. It's like, unless somebody tells you to get pissed off about something, most people don't get pissed off about stuff.
Yeah, it's definitely, I think, politically driven because everyone hates Elon Musk, but I'm not really sure why. But
I think it's mainly just he's the most like reachable of the people that like have that much influence on like our everyday life. Like he doesn't really have that much influence, but like Bill Gates isn't getting that kind of smoke online because Bill Gates isn't tweeting like jokes every day. You know what I mean?
Because Bill Gates is a fucking loser, probably socially. He's probably not a cool guy to hang out with.
But like you don't see people like Jay-Z doesn't have a fucking Instagram or a Twitter, but like if he had an Instagram and he was posting some like old dude stories, you know what I mean?
That's true.
People would be hating on him left and right. But he knows better not to do that shit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I want there to be some kind of showdown between Elon Musk and Mark Zuckerberg. Maybe Elon Musk will also buy Snapchat and some other things and create a little other empire.
I'm all for it, dude.
You know what is the perfect, actually, umbrella company? It would be Twitter, OnlyFans, and Snapchat.
Mm.
Maybe TikTok, too.
TikTok, too?
That's the path.
Twitter, OnlyFans,
that's the path to
Craigslist.
That's the path to purchase. TikTok, Snapchat, go find their porn on Twitter, and then but next thing you know, you're on OnlyFans.
Boom. Boom. Well, you know, that one day when we went to work out and get one drink after happy hour, I wound up staying up until 4 a.m. We discussed the future of social media, and we were saying that it's annoying when Snapchat had the story first, right? They had the story. And then Instagram was like, let me cop that. Let me get the story too. And then Vine had the video, and then Instagram was like, also let me get that too. We're going to do video too. And then every other fucking platform, like Facebook has a story now, and then Twitter has a story, and then you were telling
me that Twitter did a Periscope, and then Instagram was like, let me make a live function.
It's just too much. It's like, it's too much for the user to decide, is this a Twitter story or is this a Instagram story?
Or a TikTok story.
Or is this a TikTok? What the fuck is a TikTok story? A Facebook story?
Yeah, they suck.
Yeah.
I kind of get Facebook stories because it's just for people that don't use Instagram. Mm.
TikTok stories are stupid because TikToks already burn out after a day and you don't see them on your feed anymore.
Yeah. That's the whole point.
Yeah.
So I think there will be a point when every social media is combined into one. I do think that's going to happen. And then it comes down to who owns it.
And which one is going to be the more sexual?
It's all going to be one, bro. And it's going to be sexual.
Oh, okay.
It's all going to be one
when
thing.
Mark and Elon fight,
they're going to have some type of celebrity. First of all, that would be the highest grossing fight of all time. Mark Zuckerberg versus Elon Musk would be. I couldn't even imagine a person not wanting to watch that. I could not imagine talking to anyone who goes, yeah, I'm not thinking I'm gonna watch that. I mean, come on, dude. That'd be amazing. Mm-hmm. But it's gonna come down to who owns that thing. Who owns that thing? Would you rather it be Mark fucking look? You're going to have a mildly autistic, weird guy regardless. So you mean Mark Zuckerberg, who's like a robot, or Elon Musk, who's like a robot that you train to be funny? A little bit. You know? That's what I'm going for. But yeah, other qualms and quips. I feel like the whole student loan thing was coming back for a while. Did you guys notice like people talking about that like last week?
No.
You didn't see any tweets about that? Mm-hmm. I don't know why. I guess they're like introducing a new bill. Mm-hmm. And to me, this one, like not even on a political level, more on a personal level. Mm-hmm. I still can't, like, I don't, like, it's hard for me to like, want to see. I almost feel like it's like unfair a little bit. I do. I really do. Cause it's like I'm assuming you're paying off student loans right now.
I haven't started. I'm going to have to start in January or February. Uh-huh. Mm. But the new bill that they're doing, I think, in order to have loan forgiveness, you have to be delinquent for a certain amount of time. So I have to like not pay my bills for a year.
Really?
To get forgiveness. So you have to like ruin your credit to get it all deleted.
Wow.
I think that's my interpretation of it because I was like, well, I don't want to be delinquent to get rewarded later.
Yeah.
You know?
It just, like, I think that if we're basically the whole student loan forgiveness idea is predicated upon this idea that, like, colleges were overpriced and a lot of people graduated and didn't get what they thought they were going to get out of the education. So we're basically agreeing that college was a scam for a lot of people. Mm-hmm. If that is the case, then why don't we go to the colleges and say, you don't get this money? Because that's not what, as far as I understand, that's not what student loan cancellation is. What student loan cancellation is, the colleges get the money. The banks that gave you that fucking loan also get the money. And then, but the banks that get that money get it from the government. So it's not like the colleges don't get the money. Hmm. If I was a let's put ourselves in position.
So it's like a bailout?
It's a bailout. Mm-hmm. It's a fucking bailout. If I was a college and I charge 10 people a ridiculous tuition and then 9 of them, let's say 8 of them, to be fair, let's say 8 of them wind up not getting a job, even remotely justifying how much money they paid for college. Mm-hmm. And they're saying, dude, we can't pay you this tuition because your education didn't get us dick. And then I go, well, okay. And then I go to the government. I say, hey, can you give me the money instead? It's like, that's a good deal for me. If instead somebody was like, oh, dude, it's like the fucking hang bar challenge guy. Being like fucking like He's clearly doing a scam. He's clearly collecting this money from people that they know they're not going to win. Mm-hmm. And then it's like, well, that guy should be the one who gets fucked. If these colleges are the ones that are ripping people off, then why should it come out of the government money? Why don't you just say, you're not getting your fucking money, college, University of Maryland, Alabama, whatever the fuck school you are.
And then if they give everyone their money back for their tuition, whatever, or forgiveness, I mean, mm-hmm. tuition forgiveness, will we just end colleges after that to not go back to more debt? Like, no college ever. Like, I think it could go away with menthol cigarettes. We could just get rid of colleges and menthol cigarettes and
call it a
day. If
you ban menthol cigarettes, you're pretty much banning college at that point.
I agree.
You can't get rid of, I haven't even thought about this.
Keep K through 12 and non-menthols. And I think that's kind of the solve to all of our problems.
Which is why I'm trying to smoke as many as I can right now. If I'm not going to college, I at least got to smoke a bunch of menthol cigs. I just, like, when I look at things like that, like, I take it personally because it kind of says that, like, oh, the only people that took risks or made investments in their career that don't get, like, that like didn't pan out, like, oh, are the people that went to college. Basically, millennial college-educated people. What about all the other fucking people that spent money and it didn't pan out? Like, I've said this before, but, like, okay, dude, do I get a fucking forgiveness on this to the way it's going to happen? Because I want these colleges to get fucked. I want them to...
Yeah, the colleges or the loan company.
Yeah, the people giving the loans...
Neither of them can go get fucked.
It's the same thing with the fucking housing market. Like, when that happened, like, whenever these bills reach the fucking floor, you know that every motherfucker on that end of town is covered. They're covered. The colleges are getting their money. The banks are getting their money. Who's losing money? Us. Every time, dude.
So unfortunate.
Student loans, dude. Fucking student loans.
Yeah. And then other news... We don't have to talk about it too much because I mean, it's probably just kind of fucked.
Uh-huh.
The Roe versus Wade.
Yes.
Overturning.
But of course.
So that happened. So then I guess that basically what that boils down to is the federal protection of abortions, basically. So mm-hmm. now it's just a state mm-hmm. right.
Yes.
To be able to scoop that little guy out.
Mm-hmm.
So in Maryland, I think they're still A-okay.
Oh, yeah.
I think most of the blue states are pretty keen on abortions.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not too big of an issue there. But obviously, I think like Texas had a weird fucked up law about it come about recently.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't know.
It's definitely
big news. I don't really know what to say on it other than kind of sucks.
Yeah, it's...
Just for the people who are in states where... You know, they're basically just telling you, no, you can't do that. But also, we love freedom.
Oh, yeah. I really, like, when it comes to that, because we had that one guy, Brandon, on a while ago, whose, mm-hmm. like, big thing is, like, the abortion thing. And, like, even then, it's like, I honestly don't have, I tweeted this, so I'm not going to pretend like I'm saying this right now. But I don't have a strong opinion on it. I have a strong opinion on people's opinions of it. Like, I think that the way that the debate is proposed is like either you hate women or you don't. And I don't think it comes down to that. And also, I think that, like what you said, is what's going on with the Roe thing being repealed or overturned or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it goes back to the states. And what's weird about that is, like, in these states where it's not legal, it's still like it's a weird thing. I would like to see if we're going to come down to that. I just think there needs to be some, like, it's such a subjective thing to say, like, when is it a life? Myself personally, I think if we could all settle on the fucking compromise of like 3 months, I'd be cool with that. I can do 3 months. That's fine with me, dude. Like, I know that, like, there's still something that, like, sits in me that's, like, I know if I was ever in that position. Of course, I'm not a woman, so, like, blah, 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 blah. Like, if I got a girl pregnant and, like, she was, like, I'm going to get, like, should we get an abortion? I'd be like, ugh. Like, I feel like it would be something that, like, I think that there's something that sits in you where, like, people talk about, like, it's a tough decision. And it's like, well, if it's a tough decision, why is it a tough decision? Because by saying it's a tough decision, you're acknowledging that you are really actually doing something. But at the same time, you're trying to pretend like it's not doing something. Like, it's just this thing. It's just about the person who's making a decision. But it's like, well, why is it a tough decision? Is it a tough decision to get a fucking mole on your wrist removed? No. Is it a tough decision to get fucking laser hair removal? No. Is it a tough decision to get a fucking nose job? No. Then why is it a tough decision for this? And it's like, oh, because we are actually doing something here. And I feel like that type of, like, it's like, if you want to come to a compromise in that way, that'd be great. At the same time, it's hard to say. It's hard to say, dude. I mean, like you were saying before, if you live in fucking California, New York, what the fuck ever, Maryland's good, dude. I could go get an abortion right now if I wanted to. Right now. It's just like, if you do live in Texas, it's like, I don't know, dude. I don't know. Maybe take a drive. I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, it sucks because it's just like, if people need to get them, they're going to get them. And, like, now they just don't have the safe option of doing that.
Oh, totally. Totally. And it's the same thing. Like, the tweet I always see, this is, like, everyone's favorite tweet, is when they say, like, making abortions illegal won't stop abortions. It'll just stop legal abortions.
Yeah.
And then they'll be, like, you know, the same people that are against, like, gun control are against abortions. And I'm, like, you could easily reverse that and use that same argument for gun control. It's just, that's what we were talking about last week with Evan Weinstein, which is like, where being on one side or the other totally stops you from having an objective position on anything. Cause it's like, if we all understand the principle that if you make something illegal, you're not actually stopping the thing from happening, then we could also, like, I agree with that. I totally agree. Yeah. You're not, if you make abortions illegal, you're not stopping abortions. That's a fact. It's true. You're going to fucking do it one way or the other. But also, we could carry that argument right on over to the gun thing and be like, okay, so then you agree with me. And then it'd be like, no, we need to fucking stop this, stop that. So it's like, it's frustrating. And again, like, I didn't even think about bringing that up because, like, I feel like if I were to observe, I feel like we probably all have the same opinion on it, which is that, like, there's got to be a fucking point when it shouldn't happen. Like, I feel like, you know, but then you get so polarized where it's like, if you even say like 8 months and like, oh, you're going to tell somebody, it's like, I don't know, dude, like, am I allowed to say, I think that's kind of fucked up? Like, can we say that? Can you say that a fucking, like, aborting a fucking 8-month baby might be fucked up?
And it's like, you can't do that now though.
No, you can't do that now.
You can in certain states for sure, dude. New York, dude, California.
I was an 8-month baby. Look at me now.
Yeah, you were.
You were?
I was, yeah.
I thought you were a little less than that.
I think I was supposed to be born in October, and I was born in September.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, I might be wrong. I don't know.
Abortion is one of the most, I think that it is the most difficult debate ever of all debates. Definitely more than fucking gun control. Definitely more than fucking drugs and shit like that. That is a tough fucking one. Because it just comes down to, where does the life begin?
Yeah. It's interesting that we talk about abortion more than we talk about, like, just bad parents.
Yeah.
Like, you guys didn't even want to do the responsible thing and scoop that little guy out?
Scoop him out. That's just like, it's like morbid kind of, because it's like, ah, dude, like, I know that, like, it's like when you talk to, like, a couple, like, we've known people at this age that are, like, the woman gets pregnant and, like, they show the sonogram at fucking 2 months or whatever, and, like, that's their baby. Like, they're looking at it as
a little piece of, like, jerky in an x-ray.
Looks just like me. You know, it's like people, it's all like subjective kind of, because, like, and then, like, why is a miscarriage a terrible thing for a woman to go through if an abortion is nothing? Why are women fucking horrified? My mom had two. And, like, it's a very troubling situation to go.
It's also,
if it means nothing, then why?
It's Yeah, I don't know. It's weird because it's like once you intend on having a baby, then it is a baby, I guess, no matter where in the pregnancy you are.
Mm-hmm. A baby like is a state of mind.
All intentions of birthing it, that's like a person, I feel like.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, I don't know. It's weird because I don't know. I feel like just as a person, if like someone is showing pregnant, I feel like you shouldn't be able to get an abortion.
I know.
Yeah. Okay. Everything that I'm looking up now says you, in most places, it's going to be really hard to get an abortion after 4 months.
In what places?
This just says the whole country. But
yeah,
then
4 months is pretty long.
That's pretty long.
Yeah,
that's like, pretty generous.
How would you not know?
But this says the Texas thing is banning it at 6 weeks, which is only like a month and a half. So like most people don't even know they're pregnant that early. Yeah. So I do agree that is a little too short.
That's pretty short.
A month and a half. You might not even know you're pregnant.
Yeah. 6 weeks is pretty.
But 12 weeks, I think, is fine.
Yeah, it'd be fine.
You don't start showing till 4 months, I don't think. So a lot of people don't know till close to that.
Well, that's, I mean, I'm so glad we, of course, we barely ever have fucking women on this podcast. So, like, you know, whatever.
We're talking about women and Cinco de Mayo.
Yeah.
As three white guys.
This is a great time that we have an actual woman on. Or also, but more importantly, a woman who's been pregnant, too. That's a big thing, too. It's like me talking about being a dad. Okay, you're a guy, but you're not a dad.
Yeah.
You guys should have just had our moms on for Mother's Day tonight.
Mom, how would you feel if we were aborted?
If both of our moms were in these two seats.
Oh, no.
For Cinco de Mayo to talk about Roe v. Wade.
It's just like when you get to that conversation, it's like so much of it is clouded by, and that's what gets me mad. I don't get mad about people having their, I get mad at the way people have their opinion. This like thing where they like post these like Twitter, they take like screenshots of tweets and post in their story and they're like, this period is not period acceptable period. This cannot be, but it's like, all right, can you calm the fuck down for a second? And like, because if we were to sit down and be like, all right, we all just sat here like, look, 6 weeks, that's probably a little short. Like, I could totally see you not knowing you're pregnant after 6 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe. I don't know. Mm-hmm. 12 weeks, though? Now we're talking 3 months. We're talking three fucking months. It's like, you know, like, but
oh,
then,
that is 3 months. You're right.
Yeah. And then it's like, okay, so now your first trimester. And what if we try to just put the thing there? Well, then immediately someone's, well, what if someone didn't find out until 14 weeks? And you're like, okay, I see what you're saying, but like, how far does this go?
How long is a pregnancy in weeks?
36.
36? Okay.
I'm getting kind of my math mixed up. But I think we're pretty close to...
Dude.
Yeah, I feel like, you know...
Any guy who's had a pregnancy scare... Guy who's had a pregnancy scare. We all kind of get the abortion thing. We all get it.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, come on, man. I mean, when I was 21 and I thought the first girl I ever had sex with could be pregnant, I was pro-choice, bro.
Oh, yeah.
Pro fucking choice.
Yeah, pro choice, pro jumping on a train, never looking back. Pro, you know.
Pro deadbeat dad. He's got a point. It's like when you're in that situation, it's so fucking different, dude. You know? And even like right now, if I got hit, like, but that's the thing. At this age, like, I remember having that conversation with my ex-girlfriend where she was like, you got to start pulling out because. And that was kind of when I knew that the relationship was over too, because she had finally realized like, oh, like what we're doing. And she was on birth control too. It's not like we were just fucking going for gold. Like, she was on birth control, but there was even the chance of getting pregnant. She was like, we should probably stop doing that. And that's when I was like, oh, so we're not going to be together forever, I guess. Not that I was looking to have a kid, but I was just thinking, for whatever reason in my mind, I feel like girlfriends don't get pregnant. Girls that you have sex with once get pregnant. That's the way I like psychologically in my mind. Like if I
feel like that's how it most of the time happens though.
It is.
It's like anything. Like,
that's
else,
all the
like
stories you hear.
Murphy's mm-hmm. Law with anything.
Yeah. It's fucking terrible. And that's why I like being in a relationship, because there's nothing that scares me more than having a kid right now. Which is why I'm not totally fucking against abortion. But I am totally fucking against people that make it seem like it's this black and white, cut and dry, every abortion, whenever, at any point. It's like, all right, guys, come on, man. Can we wind it back a little bit here, dude? We're talking about something serious.
I just think the laws were fine how they were. I don't understand why it's... It seems weird to take something back like that, I guess.
Yeah.
That's why I find it hard to believe. It's hard for me to grasp that this is even happening. Yeah. I'm like, what? There's no way this can happen.
Invalidates all the work that like the people before them put in to be like, no, we figured it out now. We're actually wrong about this progressive thing. We're actually gonna take that back and go back a step.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Like however many years later. Like I think that's the dumbest part.
Yeah. I think this is when we really, speaking of Cinco de Mayo and countries and independence,
mm-hmm.
these are the times when we realize what the United States, we say United States all the time. And we don't think about that, what it means. And what it means is United States. The only reason any state ever signed on, because back in the day before the fucking Constitution, like Maryland was Maryland. Fucking Pennsylvania was Pennsylvania. We like kind of had some good shit going on, blah, 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 blah. But we were all colonies and we were all like doing our own thing. And the only reason that all these states signed on to be one thing, one country, was because we were basically saying like, all right, you guys can pretty much do whatever the fuck you want outside of this Constitution. Like anything that's in this Constitution, we control. The country controls. Everything outside of that, take it away. Knock your fucking self out. If you want to be a state that makes all drugs illegal, go for it. You know, if you want to live in a state that does, and that's why, like, even the federal illegalization of marijuana was such a silly thing, because it's like, there's nothing in the fucking Constitution that says fucking weed. And that's why it's like, there's times when, like, people play the, even like people on the right will be like, well, it's constitutional, but then they'll be the same people to be like, yeah, but weed should be illegal. It's like, but like, if you're going to be a constitutionalist, then you have to admit that, like, there's really only, the only thing that the country should control are these specific things. And at that point, it's like, okay, well, then you live in a state that sets its own fucking rules. We live in Maryland, and Maryland's going to set our own fucking rules, right? Like, we live in a state where it's, like, predominantly, like, blue, and they're going to fucking do what they want to do with abortion, and we don't have a problem. But then what's weird about these days is, like, 200 years ago, nobody in Maryland would have given a fuck what the abortion law in Texas was. The people that should be worried about the abortion law in Texas are the people in Texas. And if the people in Texas disagree with it, they can change it. That's what a democracy is. I mean, that's the whole fucking point, right?
Yeah,
the reality.
What about the United States, dude?
I mean, but like at a certain point, like I think what makes our country work is that like, dude, I don't think Maryland should have the same laws as California or Texas. We're different fucking people. You know, if we were in fucking Europe, we'd be six countries away from each other. Like, Greece doesn't have the same fucking laws as Norway. And they're probably closer than we are to Texas. Like, this idea of this gigantic country all having one exact set of things that we live by, it's like, people in LA don't understand the mindset of people in fucking Mississippi. They don't. They make fun of them. They think they're fucking idiots. We think people in Mississippi are idiots. I think people in Mississippi are idiots. I don't necessarily, but like, we look at them different. I don't think people in Mississippi are idiots, but like, we see how we're different. Mm-hmm. And it's like, if you go to fucking Mississippi, it's like, I'm not going to go to fucking Utah and be like, oh, you guys are fucking stupid with your 3% beers and your fucking blow. It's like, you don't live here, bro.
And your anal sex and everything. Yeah.
And your fucking 17 wives. Like, okay, dude, you know what? This is why you live in Utah mm-hmm. and I live in Maryland. That's okay.
I miss Utah.
That's okay.
A sore subject for
that's
Alex.
A sore subject. I'm sorry to invoke Utah.
I forgot to leave some hate comments on Sundance's Instagram the other day.
I think you should. I really still think smooth segueing out of the most hot topic debate of all time. But I really do think if you haven't yet, you should have screenshotted that your bank returned that statement.
Oh, yeah. I DM'd some of my friends and said, hey, I got my refund. Mm-hmm. But I didn't post it.
You got to post it.
And then Sundance announced, like, I think yesterday or the day before, they're like, 2023, we're going to be back in person in Park City. And I'm planning to comment, yeah, right. And then next I'm going to comment, I've heard that before.
Oh, dude. See, here's the thing.
I might do it right now.
You got to wait for the next tweet.
Oh, because it's
got to be the early. Post is old. It's got to be early in the post.
We're all aspiring clout gods here. You don't comment on a tweet 3 days after the tweet and expect any love.
And, yeah, you got to be within like the first 5 minutes.
It was 2 days ago when they posted
it. It's over, dude. You got to wait for the next announcement. You got to like have notifications on your phone. That's not a terrible idea. I think I'm just going to set notifications on my phone for like every person that tweets that I might respond to.
I'm going
to
do that.
You know, because that's kind of how you blow up on Twitter. I don't know about Elon Musk's Twitter, but that's how you grow. That's how you blow up on the old Twitter.
Oh, I just typed Twitter into Twitter. Sundance.
Also, speaking of Twitter, I'm just going to put this out here right now. We don't have to talk about it.
Hmm.
We don't have to talk about it.
Hmm.
I'm going to make a bet with the world. If Donald Trump is allowed back on Twitter, his first tweet will be the most retweeted tweet of all time.
Mm. Oh, I thought you were going to try to guess what he's going to tweet.
No. I think he's just going to say something like, miss me? Question mark. It's got to be something short. You can't like do like a long fucking like, hey, man, it's been a tough 2 years. Good, dude. No, you just got to do something like awesome. I think that will be the most retweeted tweet of all time.
Just the clown emoji.
Is that like Elon's big goal with buying Twitter, getting Donald Trump back on it?
I think it's one of them. I could see it being one of them, dude.
Yeah.
I could definitely see it being one of them. I mean, I don't think that was what he was thinking. Because honestly, if Donald Trump wanted to be back on Twitter, I mean, how much is Twitter again? No, I guess, yeah. Elon Musk is apparently the most rich guy in the world. I thought it was Jeff Bezos up until like yesterday.
Hmm.
Oh, me too.
The richest guy in the world think he's fluctuating.
Hmm.
Yeah, I don't know.
And me being the most middle class guy in the world, I want to know.
For some reason, that I just keep getting poorer for some reason. I don't know why.
The most middle class man.
Yeah, that was big news. What else was big news?
Well, Dave Chappelle got assaulted at his comedy gig.
True.
Yeah, true. That did happen.
True. Can we pull that video up?
That sucks about that is obviously it sucks that like that's just going to be a normal thing now.
Because of copycat
stuff. Do you think that was because of the Will Smith thing?
100%.
So I saw something. I don't know if this was true or not. It might have just been like Photoshopped. But people were like posting a tweet that went like semi-viral and was like, you know, showed like Will Smith slapping Chris Rock. And then it was like, your next Dave Chappelle, like stop coming after all of my trans friends or something. And it had like 60,000
really
likes. And then apparently that's the guy that went up on stage to try to attack him.
Was it? Was it really the same person?
I don't know. That's the thing. Because I heard spreading misinformation.
Well, I don't know. I'm a little behind on news too. Wait, what's today? Thursday? I heard about this on a podcast today. But I heard that when he got hit, his response was, that was a trans man or something like that.
Mm.
Maybe because he was thinking like, oh, I wonder if this is the person from online.
Behind yeah, I don't know.
The DJ table is one of the most prolific producers that hip hop has ever presented, the mighty Mad Lib. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for hip hop history.
Yeah, apparently he.
For all he listens, this is slow motion.
Yeah, he Dang. Ran up and tried to tackle him and, like, almost didn't.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he was horizontal at one point, like holding Dave Chappelle.
Jesus.
I am going to kill that.
Oh.
Wait, I gotta see this.
Yeah, apparently just like him and a bunch of famous dudes beat up this guy.
Oh, I thought it was his security.
Well, probably his security too. I think Jamie Foxx was there in
dude,
the mix.
His arm was like bent the other way.
Apparently like that kid is getting charged with assault with a deadly weapon because he snuck in like a fake gun, but it had like a flip out knife in it.
Yeah, which is the weirdest thing ever.
And also, how do you sneak that into a show? Because I've been to a Dave Chappelle show.
You can't
before.
Even get a phone in.
You can't take your phone in. You have to like walk through metal detectors. You got to get patted down. Like, first red flag. What's this thing that feels like a gun? And then he takes it out. He's like, oh, don't worry. It's
just a
fake. It's just a knife.
Don't worry. It's just. I don't get the whole problem. Like, I understand sneaking in a knife that's actually a gun because you're disguising something more dangerous as something less dangerous. Mm-hmm. He snuck in something less dangerous disguised as something more dangerous.
Yeah. The idiom is don't bring a knife to a gunfight, right?
Yeah. That's like sneaking in a knife and be like, just kidding. It's a sponge. Like, what? It's the other way around, dude. You're bad at sneaking things, dude.
Knives are the new sponges.
What like, if you thought the saying was, don't bring a knife and a gun?
And like, don't bring a knife in a gunfight. Wow, dude. So, yeah, I guess I didn't put two and two together on the whole thing. Like, maybe the whole Chris Rock situation has inspired people to think that you can just fucking tackle motherfuckers now.
You can just walk up on stage. You don't think so, Eric?
Well, here's the thing. There are people dumb enough out there to believe that and also do that, which sucks.
Oh, yeah.
Just like copycat killers and like serial killers
exactly.
type stuff.
Or
school shootings, sorry.
Yeah.
School shootings.
The most annoying thing, though, is that this like validated all the shitty like open micer takes of being like, comedy is not safe anymore. Like, I have to fight for my life every night.
Oh, yeah.
In a bar of five people. I avoid drinks being thrown at me and, like, I'm afraid for my life and I need security now. It's like, fuck off. But then this happens and you're like, God damn it.
Yeah, because I did hear a podcaster say,
I don't want
those
fucking idiots to be right.
After the Will Smith thing. Mm-hmm. And they were saying the same thing that you're just saying. And then when this happened, they were like, I totally called it. I said it. Once it happened once, it's going to happen to other stand-ups. And then people are going to think it's okay to just go up and like rush the stage.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I agree. I think it's less of a thing of like punching. Well, it's weird because it kind of is, but it's not because I agree with you. It's like, dude, shut up. You're not like on the front lines of the fucking.
Yeah, jokingly, you'd be like, yeah, they're not going after you. They're going to go after Dave Chappelle.
Yeah.
And it's like, oops.
Oh.
Oh, I spoke that into existence.
But yeah, the copycat thing is real.
Yeah.
Like, the copycat thing is real. Mm-hmm. Like the idea of smacking a comedian went viral. Now, the difference is this guy, I think the copycat thing is now over officially because Will Smith kind of got to slap Chris Rock and then walk away.
Yeah, you saw the best case scenario.
Yeah.
He slapped Chris Rock and then won an award and didn't get kicked out, didn't get beat up.
Same time.
Two sides of the spectrum.
Also brings more questions to mind. Conspiracy. When Will Smith attacked Chris Rock, it's like, dude, where was security then? Is it because he's Will Smith? They were just like, fuck it.
I think it's because it was the Oscars and it was a limited group and they just weren't expecting anything.
It was like live, right? Wasn't that live?
Yeah, but wasn't that live?
But it's only at the Oscars, it's just a very select echelon of people who they all know each other. There's no You're normal people security. There. They don't think anything like that would happen because it's no just normie. The insider.
I bet they didn't think video of that was going to get out because usually all of his shows are locked down like that, you know?
Yeah, that's true too. That might be why that's the only angle is because that guy had to sneak in a phone disguised as a gun.
Yeah.
Got it. Yeah, dude, that's fucking crazy, dude. And then also it's like, yeah, when you talk about like,
apparently Chris Rock came out after that happened and said, was that Will Smith?
Awesome line.
Yeah, that was funny.
Awesome line. Awesome line. Because
he happened to be there, right?
Yep. Mm-hmm. So maybe Chris Rock is...
Chris Rock paid that kid like 10 bucks. Like, go up on stage, go hassle him. I got a good joke.
This joke's only going to work if you get your arm bent backwards.
Hey, do that thing with your arm.
Was that Will Smith?
Good, good, good.
Perfect. Yeah, dude, honestly, like going back to like the, oh, we know everybody here, like no security. Sometimes I get a little weird at the point that they don't have any security.
That's true.
They're the only bar in town that doesn't have bouncers.
What if our drunk aunt comes up and takes a tambourine?
There have been times.
We need a bouncer for that.
I would have yeah. You score this one out and give me my tambourine back. There have been times when I would have wished for a bouncer, you know, at the point. I remember specifically, I remember one time we were at the point. This is over the summer 2020. Mm-hmm. Maybe even 2019. And it was with two blonde girls we used to hang out with. And we had discovered somebody had seen over the other shoulder of somebody else's phone that this guy at the corner of the bar was like taking pictures of the two girls. And then like somebody was like, yo, let me see your fucking phone. Like, I see what you're doing, blah, blah, blah. And then the guy was like, oh, no, he deleted them. And then they checked his recently deleted, and it was all these pictures of them.
Oh, dummy.
And so it, like, started this fight between, like my brother's coworkers and this dude. And then I remember, like, seeing it go down, and then the bartender was like, Jimmy, stop this. Jimmy, blah, blah, blah. And I was thinking in my mind, I was like,
I'm a customer.
I'm a customer.
What the fuck?
Like, come on. You know?
Am I going to get paid?
Yeah. It was, that's one of those moments, like, you guys probably should have security. Like, people get in fights at bars.
Mm-hmm.
That's a normal thing. You know? Maybe they're planning on, oh, the bombs are so expensive, nobody's going to get a fucking
that's
fight.
What I was going to say. There's no really no fights at the point, because it's so too expensive. None too of the college kids go there, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You can't get kicked out on one bomb. It's like, Jesus Christ. Losing investment. I did actually, there was a fight in Canton the other night that happened. Fights are fun in a weird way. Like, they're like...
As an observer, sure.
As an observer, they're very fun. And like, and
as long as you're not too close to it.
It's always like, you know, like, it was weird. It was what, you know how they have that expression, like, on site, it's on site. So this one, like, they both look like quintessential fuckboys. It was the ultimate two fuckboys. Like, one guy had, like the short sides with, like, the fucking thing, like, gelled back. He looked like you. Actually, one guy actually did kind of look like you. He looked like a white trash you.
And he was in a fight?
He was in a fight. Nice. It's pretty badass.
Did he win?
The white trasher guy won.
I knew it. Okay.
The white trasher guy did win.
I support that.
So, like, basically, one dude's walking up to the bar. He's in, like, a button-up, untucked, like, three buttons down. Kind of had like a little Latin looking flair to him.
Oh, no undershirt.
No undershirt. Of course not, dude. And then the other guy that looked like you was walking out of the bar, and then they just saw each other in the middle of the street and immediately just start fighting.
Damn.
And like, so blah, 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 blah. But they're like, there's like little fucking scuffle, and then like two groups of people pulled them away. And then it became like, then they're like trying to talk. Then the bouncer's just like, yo, you guys can fight, just not in front of our store. Which is a classic bouncer thing, because bouncers don't give a fuck,
yeah,
you know?
Not my problem.
Yeah, not my problem, you know? So now these guys are like, now they're in the middle of the street, and like they're both doing the classic white trash thing where it's like...
They gotta pull their pants up.
Yeah.
And they just have them held up. They're just like, yeah, yeah,
yeah,
yeah.
Somebody give me my belt. And like just trying to like act like they want to fight, but not want to fight. And you know both of them are just praying to God that somebody puts an end to this. Because ultimately, when you're in a fight, you really just want somebody to break it up. That's really what you secretly want. And no man will admit this, but that is the truth. Mm-hmm. You don't want to... If you're winning, maybe. But if you're like in the middle of it, it's like, well, I get knocked out. And best case scenario, they get knocked out. But like more reasonable scenario is it's like it's dangerous for both of us. You know, somebody please don't let us fight so I can act like I wanted to fight, but not actually have to fight. Mm-hmm. You know, give me an out. Give me an out.
Yeah, I don't want to look like a pussy. So
the bouncers weren't giving them an out. The bouncers were just like, fight over there. Mm-hmm. And everybody at the bar is just like watching. And then so like it kind of like de-escalates. And then all of a sudden out front of Colada, one guy just tackles the other guy and they just start fighting and blah, 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 blah. And it was another one of those situations where it was like it's one of those situations where you realize like whenever people talk about like, just rely on like the police for protection and shit. Like it's like, there's no cops. The bouncers weren't doing anything. It's just two dudes beating the fuck out of each other in the middle of the fucking square. And then everybody's going like, oh, somebody should break that up. I was like sitting there with Lucas and we were like, what the fuck do we do? So eventually I like ran down there because the one guy was like, I kind of wanted to let it go so there could be like one decisive victory. You know what I mean? Because mm-hmm. like if they both feel like it's kind of like with animals. I've been watching a lot of animals lately. And like when they fight, they don't fight to the death because that's retarded. Like there's no hospitals in the fucking Serengeti, dude.
That is scary.
It's scary. Mm-hmm. Like you get in a fight, it's like, dude, like I'm going to fight you until I feel like one of us would probably win. And then the other one of us is going to like run away. And it sucks in the animal kingdom. It's kind of brutal. I mean, it's very brutal because it's like he's just like, okay, well, I have your family now.
Yeah, I'm taking all of your bitches.
All your bitches are mine. All your kids are mine, too. I might keep them alive. I might eat them.
Yeah,
who knows?
Probably eat them.
I'll probably eat them because I don't want any more of your offspring in, like, my thing here. Like, it's kind of crazy being an animal, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Luckily, well, we are animals, but we're not, like, that much of an animal.
No doubt about that.
But then you see these... oh, we're animals, baby. You see these dudes? So I was like, let me just let it go until, like, one guy is, like, on top of the other guy. Because then that guy subconsciously... The guy on the bottom subconsciously knows, like, I was losing. I'm glad it was broken up. And the other guy subconsciously knows, like, I was winning. And I don't have a need to, like, go and prove anything anymore. Mm-hmm. He knows I won. I know I won. So that's when I like kind of pulled him off or whatever. It was like weird because it's like.
You don't know either of them.
I'm not security, bro.
So you helped out?
Yeah, but
you
it's
weren't
like,
even at that bar.
I wasn't even at that bar. I don't know these guys, dude. But like, what's the bouncers doing? Lawless, dude. Fucking lawless down there, dude. Mm. Truly. All kinds of stuff spurred out of the whole the guy who was just shot in Fells Point recently.
Mm-hmm.
Dude, I was playing at the horse last night and like, dude, I was talking about it last year, but mm-hmm. it's really, really palpable like how much of a thing it's affecting people down there.
Especially because you worked down there so much. Like,
yeah.
Have you played at Riptide since then?
No, I haven't. But I'm not saying that it affects me.
Mm-hmm.
Not that I don't care. I didn't know the guy. I definitely care because it's like, Jesus, I almost feel like it's like every 2 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
And like a lot of times it's like, a lot of times when you hear about these things happening, it's like, it seems so distant because it's like, mm-hmm. oh, that was like, a lot of times it's like, well, that was this guy doing some drug shit and the other guy doing some drug shit, killed the other guy. It's like, okay, whatever. I'm not ever getting involved in that. But then it's like, you hear, it's like, oh, that was just a guy
mm-hmm.
working the door 2 feet away from where I fucking play inside Riptide. Got mm-hmm. fucking shot. It's like, now it's like, it just keeps on coming, creeping closer.
Mm-hmm.
Just creeping closer to the point where I'm like, I do really start having second thoughts about like, do I want to be down here all the time? Like mm-hmm. on an off night? Because that's when it usually happens, is an off night.
Right.
Not mm-hmm. crowded. It's like, I'm coming down here on a fucking Wednesday night, barren streets. I don't want to be fucking doing that. And like, dude, these fucking one of the bartenders are just going fucking like yelling and just like being like, I'm tired of fucking seeing this, blah, blah, blah. And like he was friends with the guy. And I was like, damn, it's really starting to affect people a lot.
That sucks.
A lot. Yeah. Something's got to be done. I think I could do that fucking tax thing they did again.
Yeah. Just stop something. Paying taxes.
Something.
Yeah.
I'm happy to not pay taxes.
Yeah. That'd be kind of sick. What if we, all of us, just stop paying taxes?
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Nationwide movement.
Nationwide movement. No taxes. Something. Something's got to happen. Something. Dude. I'm not trying to be fucking
shot. I just
want to
benefit from it, too.
Yeah, well, of course I want to benefit from it. I would love if I could get a refund for the fucking $2,000. I just, here you go, government. If I could just get that back, you know, that'd be nice. But, yeah, it's getting weird. It's getting weird. It felt like it was getting good for a second, and then it started getting weird again, and it's like, I don't know. Just the older I get, the older you get, the more you start to kind of weigh out, like, all right, like, when you're 21, you don't think anything could happen to you, and then when you're 29, you're like, oh, I mean, I am down here a lot, and certainly seems to be happening a lot, so I almost feel like it's like, who the fuck, who's out in the middle of the streets with expensive stuff at late hours of the night with nobody else around all the time? Oh, me.
Yeah.
Maybe.
But also, like, I feel like there's a step between the money and, there's no immediate gain. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm not too sure there's many, like, drug fiend, like, well, actually, no. A lot of really good guitar players are.
Oh, yeah. The best. The best.
The best.
Are drug fiends. Yes.
So they might even just take the guitar to play it.
Yes.
You show to the horse on a Wednesday and be like, wait, that's my guitar. Also, aren't I supposed to be playing tonight?
He's like, yeah, I do more drugs than you. Therefore, I am better than you at guitar. I'm like, well, he's got a point.
Yeah.
He's got a fucking point.
But I just mean, like, I feel like if someone's messing with someone late night down there, they're probably getting a bartender, a waitress, or some shit.
Yeah,
that's like easy. You're like, okay, tip money fast.
Well, this
if
one
they
was
steal
just,
your shit. It's like now I gotta go sell this.
This one was just like an altercation. It was apparently what happened was the one guy, like, was riding down the street on one of those scooters, and then just like they were like, I guess they were like younger, like underage, and the bouncer didn't let him in. And so later on in the night, the kid was driving down on a scooter and threw it at the bouncer. And the bouncer was like, what the fuck? And threw the scooter back at him. And then the kid pulled out a gun and shot him three fucking times.
Oh, my Jesus God. Christ.
And it's like that kind of shit. Because it's like, dude, there's a civilized way of handling this. Like, if you guys were to get in like a fist fight or something, like, that's normal shit. But like, just the idea that there's people walking around that they think that a reasonable next step to something like that, you didn't let me in a bar, so I'm going to throw a scooter at you. And then when you react in the exact same way, I'm going to kill you. And it's like, what the fuck are we dealing with here?
Mm-hmm.
That's insane. Yeah. When I heard that last night, I was like, are you serious, bro?
I hadn't heard that of
fucking
story
wild.
About what happened, yeah.
And that was, you know, that's not a verified account, but it's somebody who I would trust to give the correct account.
Jeez.
So, but yeah, so that sucks. But, you know.
The world is ending.
The world is ending. On the bright side.
Man, dude,
as we,
did the world really end in, was it 2012?
2020. Oh.
There's reason.
Started going bad. 2020,
There
yeah,
is.
I guess it was probably 2012 or 2020.
Well, we just
the
talked about this recently because I read something on, or no, I saw something on TikTok where I get most of my news, verified news. And I don't know, some crazy thing with the Mayan calendar. We miscounted, and actually what we thought was their 2012 was actually our 2020 or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
So like when we thought the world was going to end in 2012, it actually ended in 2020. It was one theory.
Okay. See, I could see that, but also I think there's a reasonable argument to say that we kind of did take a weird timeline starting 2012.
Yes, I remember you brought that up when I told you this theory. You were like, well, did we really change in 2020 or did it really start back in...
It seemed different.
2010-ish.
It seemed different. I'm gonna go take a piss real quick, by the way, guys.
Damn,
sorry.
I need to take a piss. Also, don't. I have to go down soon.
Oh yeah, true. Well, I guess we can wrap it up while we're here, since the world's already over for the past 10 years. What are we still doing? World's been over for 10 years.
I guess.
Here we are doing this podcast, I guess. On the bright side, plugs for other people. John Burkhart playing with Peachface at this very moment. Actually, at this very moment, an hour and a half ago. So they're done. Mm. But Canton First Thursday is fucking sick. It's back. I literally feel like every single person I've talked to is going there.
Mm-hmm.
It's weird. It's like it's the biggest thing going on right now.
Mm-hmm.
Which honestly kind of made it less appetizing to me because I was like, Jesus. I mean, fucking long-ass lines for beers.
Yeah.
Nowhere to take a piss. But whatever. You know, you got to make hay while the sun shines. As far as actual plugs for us, you got anything?
I have something, but I can't think of it right now. I got to pee really bad, so just follow me at Eric Glazer.
Got you. Let's see. Guys, this upcoming week, I'll be at the Valley Inn tonight, Friday, May 6th, 7 to 11. Saturday, May 7th at Nacho Mama's, 4 to 7. Every Tuesday at the Perennial, or just Perennial, in Towson, 5 to 8:30. And every Wednesday in Fells Point, 9:30 to 1:30 a.m. with the venerable Jason Heiser. We also have a sick-ass event coming up. The date has been moved for the Booze Belt Bash at Das Beer Hall. We'll be holding that Thursday, May 19th. We got some comedy coming at you. We got some live music coming at you. It kicks off at 8 p.m.
That was what I forgot.
Well, there you have it, folks. Das Beer Hall, Thursday, May 19th, 8 p.m. all night. We got some drink specials. I'm pitching them, seeing what sticks. We'll find out. At Jimmy Celeste on everything, at LFTS Podcast on everything. Alex, got anything to plug?
I don't have any projects to promote. I'm kind of just working on myself right now.
Nice.
Excellent. So we're going to plug Alex Glazer as a being. Folks, we'll see what song this is.
If you like pina colada.
That'd be sick. Okay, this is not what I thought it was going to be. It says Cinco de Mayo for kids. All right, kids.
We are going to learn facts.
Leave it.
This isn't a song.
I like it.
This isn't a song at all. Till next Cinco de Mayo, folks.
Peace. Talk to everyone about it and be like, Cinco de Mayo is so cool, and I understand it because I saw the video.